a little bit about the whole Natalie situation. I came across a post in the subreddit today, and I agree with pretty much everything said in the subreddit. And all of these are great questions, and they need to be, or they should be asked. And it would be nice if they were answered. And I'm very happy I read this, because this brought me to a couple of realizations that I really hadn't reached before. And also just reminded me that let's focus on what we know. And I believe, I know, I've been probably the most guilty of speculation when it comes to this subject, more so than most people, I think. But for now, let's just focus on what we know. I'm going to entertain some speculation here, but I want to just point out what we know first, okay? So there's a few things here in the subreddit that I read that I just want to use as like a roadmap throughout this conversation. And I want to try and make this video quick if I can. So we're going to start off with how, that as someone says that if everything led back to Katie, why did anything come of it? And that's true. I want to point out though, it isn't just Katie that nothing came of it from. It's alleged to have led back to Little Miss Noble and to Natalie, but nothing came of that either. And any which way you look at it, I know I've made arguments or whatever as to regarding whether or not Natalie was even arrested. I still wonder these things. But whether or not she was arrested, what we know now is a stance. There's not a current investigation into Natalie regarding this situation. She's not been charged with anything, let alone convicted or punished or whatever. So that's what we know. And to which I reiterate this question, why didn't anything come of this for anyone involved? Someone else points out how you can't really put this past Katie because she's gone pretty low before. To which I want to remind people, this is true. She went so low as to even call her own kid the R word in a live stream chat just so she could make it look like somebody else said it. And she could make that person look bad and wrong and make Katie look like the just innocent victim in all of this. Someone says, the only thing I find weird is if Nat is falsely accusing Katie of crimes, why hasn't Katie talked about it? She loves every opportunity to play the victim. This is true. However, though, Katie right now is talking about being the victim for 7M. She's going to have a hard time pinning all kinds of nefarious activity on Nat and working on behalf of 7M, since Nat already has a history here in this community. So if she starts claiming to be Nat's victim now, then it takes away from the argument that 7M is responsible for any of the bad shit that she says is happening to her. It gives another culprit, basically. And right now, Katie wants the only culprit to be 7M. I just don't know what Katie would get out of it. If she used this for money and sympathy, I'd understand more, but I don't pretend to know what's going on in her head. To which you said it right there, I think. I mean, unless you value and hold dear the things that Katie does, you can't really know what you're going to value and hold dear as being the same as Katie. And I think that that's an excellent point to make. I also want to point out that I think that in Katie's mind, she's right about this. There's the court of law and then a court of public opinion. And you can't really do the same things to win it both at the same time, because one is run by largely emotion, the other one is largely run by logic and reasoning. So the actions you take in your efforts to win in each are going to be dramatically different, I think. I think Katie mostly cares about the court of public opinion, because really who cares if the court deems you to be something? It's the people around you, where you live, your community, that you care about. So that makes sense to me anyway. I absolutely believe it could be Nat, but the problem is Katie has cried wolf so many times and has, again, blamed other creators and now Shin, instead of even mentioning the real possibility of Natalie. As far as I've seen, at least, I think if there is proof Natalie was behind the last circus, it shouldn't be too hard to establish she's responsible for this as well. Okay, here's the thing. That's been my question too. Like, not even just this time, but if we go back to the whole first time this happened during the Tati Westbrook trial lawsuit, when Katie received that recovery email notification, she didn't she didn't contact Google first. She didn't try to contact the email address that was trying to enact this recovery email. She didn't try to contact them, at least not that we've seen. She didn't She didn't question if it was somebody else behind it. She came right out the gate onto Twitter and blamed exactly who she believed it to be or wanted it to be without any care or concern. And like this person pointed out here that, you know, Kitty's done this time and time again and blamed this creator and that creator. Now she's blaming Shin, you know, and that might be why she's not talking about Natalie so much right now, because she doesn't want to take away from her being able to blame everything that she says is going on Shin. If Natalie is known to be back in the picture here, then, you know, it's going to fuck up Katie's plans, possibly. You know, people are going to be like, well, wait a minute, this person did this to you before. Why do you think it's him? Like, holy shit, maybe Shin's not really this crazy culty guy. I'm just saying, I'm speculating there. But my question remains, though, why did she just come out and know exactly, allegedly, who to blame, who was behind it? She didn't bother to ask any questions. And again, this time, she's not doing that. And it seems like whenever she does this, it's whoever she, the flavor of the week is, whoever she's mad at. But also, I want to point out here something. What if, I don't believe that there's any investigation going on. Mostly because usually when there is one going on, you don't want to tip off the suspects. I can't imagine what FBI is not only okay with Katie doing this, but seemingly in support of Katie doing this, since they have allegedly devoted an entire agent to all things Katie Joy. But I want to know how or who are okay with Katie taking all of this information, even this evidence that the FBI has been so generous to share with Katie. They're fine with her taking all that and putting it all out on blast on social media to explain their thoughts and steps and actions throughout the entire investigation as it's happening. And to go after and attack the alleged perpetrators, thus muddying the waters, if you will. So I'm kind of curious, what FBI is okay with that? And not only okay with it, but in support of it, that they gave her her own agent, really, to like tend to her needs. And I mean, this must be what happened, because she was able to utilize this agent, Steve, when she had all those issues with the Chrisleys, with Todd Chrisley and Lindsay Chrisley. Well, I mean, for granted, this is all according to Katie. So this is only true if we are to take her word for it. Yeah, I know. This person says, I believe it's Natalie too. What I don't believe is what Natalie is saying in the emails. I don't believe Katie is messaging her. Of course not. Threatening people from her emails. Salt said Natalie admitted to faking emails and messages. And I think that's exactly what she's doing now. I'm just shocked that Nikki believes Natalie. Nikki doesn't know what to think. I can't speak for her, honestly. I really can't. But if I were to guess, she doesn't know what to think. She just knows that she's getting these things and she's annoyed. And she's just like, you know what? I'm not dealing with it. Put it out there for everyone else can fucking fight over it. You know, let me know what y'all come up with. That's, in my opinion, that's what Nikki's doing. And I don't blame her there. So there's a reason why so many people think Katie had like some like hand or whatever in all of this before. And this goes back to the days of Unirock. I'm going to share this screenshot. I shared it the other night in my stream. I want to share it now, though, too. So this is a screenshot of a private Discord conversation between Unirach, who was Unirock's girlfriend, is now his wife, and Katie Joy. This happened in December 2020, right after Unirock. Stop it. Right after Unirock. Get down. Kicked Katie Joy out of his server for allegedly doxing Creepshow art. So it goes on to say, Unirach says, and this was after Katie was served with her lawsuit, okay? It says, Katie, I just talked to Uni. He's not mad at you, but no matter how scary it gets, please keep having faith and trust him as a friend. He promises you everything will work out, like in December. He just needs time to upload and live stream, and it'll all work out in the end. So this is why I think, by and large, why so many people are of the belief that last time, no, Katie wasn't directly involved. It was her lawsuit. I don't think she really could have taken that risk anyway. But that the Uni fam assisted her in her endeavors there. And but now this time, I think if anyone is doing this, I am of the belief that it is in fact Katie directly doing it. But I'm speculating, and I said I wouldn't do that. I say that I think it's her behind this now because she's making mistakes in her efforts to do the same shit she's done in the past. Like with the whole Domino's receipt thing. Despite popular belief, the rewards points, it only shows up on the receipt if you're not signed in. So there's those rewards points wouldn't be attributed to anyone yet because there's no account holder associated with that order. And I tested this out. When you sign up for the rewards program and you order through your rewards account so that you get the rewards points, it doesn't print up on top of their receipt because it doesn't need to. It's going to, it knows it's you. It's going into your account. So you don't have to call and submit them or anything. The website did that for you. But if you order a pizza without signing into a rewards account, that's a non-account holder, then it will print up at the top of the receipt. And it does it, it's kind of like an advertising thing. Like, hey, you didn't sign up for these things. Come get your shit, you know? That's what it does. That's why it does it. But I have my receipt here. So, and I was a new customer too. See, new customer, no rewards thing up here. Because when I ordered it online, I was signed into my rewards account. The one I just made, too. It's my first order on it. I also want to point something else out. So, right here. See right here? The circle? There's over here. There's nothing there. Okay, so how it works is, if it's delivery, it's going to say delivery right there. It will then also include any delivery instructions should you give them any. If you don't give them any instructions, it'll just say delivery because it's still a delivery. If you eat it there, it'll say dine in. If you walk in there and order it there to take out, it'll say carry out. For some reason, when you order online as a pickup, it doesn't say anything though. And that's what I did. So, also too, I want to point out, someone mentioned how this Domino's that the order came from, because at the top of her receipt, there's a number, like a location number. It's something like 15 miles away from her house. It's a good distance away. Domino's doesn't deliver that far. Like, I don't think any pizza place will deliver that far. So chances are it was a pickup. And she's trying to make it look like it was Robert Shin, to the point where when they placed the order, they represented themselves as a new customer named Robert Shin. And the phone number that they had crossed out there, I wonder whose number that is. I mean, did they just put any number in there? Did it matter? They were just going to cross it out and they knew that? Or did they actually obtain Robert Shin's number and put it in there? And then she thought, I better not dox the man with his number, you know? Because then no one will believe that he's behind this, because he would never actually put his number on there, right? So I don't know. But I know what I stated here about the receipt. Stop it. What are you whining for? Stop it. She was investigated and let go. DC Hawking, the detective in the UK, confirmed with me, Detective New York, that the FBI didn't state that NK was responsible for anything or even a subject in their investigation, making Saltz a liar. Saltz didn't respond to any questions about Natalie after she was cleared either. Okay, so I'm not sure about this whole comment. I say that because I myself have tried to contact DC Hawking and I've gotten no reply. Not even when Katie went on a stream and said, if you receive any emails from her, she's not allowed to contact anyone, be sure to report them to, you know, this investigator. I received an email after that. I contacted the investigator. No one even got back to me then. So, and I tried reaching out to get any kind of confirmation about this from someone. No one will answer me regarding that, okay? I find that suspect. Even when I said that I have information to help you in your investigation, no one got back to me. So, I don't know about that. It's nothing more than my own curiosity. I wonder if, like, maybe throughout this whole thing, if everyone was of the belief that some fuckery was going on. And then throughout settlement talks or whatever, efforts in which to settle with Tati and Katie, if it then became known that Katie had somehow orchestrated this, then, but they were left maybe in a position where they can out this information and ruin or potentially harm their case against, you know, with Clark Swanson, since they needed Katie to remain to look like a credible witness for them. If that was the case, they might have been faced with a difficult decision and they had to do what was best for them, which case I don't blame them. That's where I am on the whole DC Hawking thing. I talk about this in another stream I did. I'm gonna link that here. Right up here, you're going to see a little eye pop up. It's going to be to a link to a stream I did some time ago regarding the validity of Nat and the arrest and the investigation and all that. some interesting information in there. So it's a little bit long, but I cover a lot of angles. So check it out. And someone else says she's an actual person. The FBI was involved at one point and questioned her. I question all of this myself. Here's what I do know, and I think we do know. There was someone with the red hair, you know, that face and everything, that took on the title or whatever, if you will, of Natalie Kennett, for at least, if not entirely, for the purposes of videos and such regarding this lawsuit. I don't know if that means that there is, in fact, a Natalie Kennett somewhere, or there isn't, or I don't know. I don't know beyond that there is a physical face behind the name, at least depicted to social media. Beyond that, I don't know the answer to this question. But I do know that on social media, there has been an actual person, an actual face put to the name. That's what I do know. KJ's tips email wasn't capitalized, but this one is. It's likely spoofing again. Just document and keep it moving. Okay, the more you feed it, the bigger it grows. Learn from the last one. This is true. Yes, skeleton key. For those who don't know, the skeleton key was a movie, 15, 20 years ago or something, with Kate Hudson, where like the tagline of the movie was like something like, if you don't believe in it, it can't hurt you, or some shit like that. So her character starts off with regarding like voodoo worship, not believing in it. But because she's surrounded by it, she starts to kind of look at her world basically from the eyes of, is this real? And eventually she ends up being completely and totally bought into the idea and that the shit's real, in which case that's when she loses. So I think that is very much like the skeleton key, or at least all of this drama is. The more you breathe life into it, the more it'll exist. If you don't breathe life into it, it can't exist. But I want to now comment on here about the capitalization. This is true. Email is not case sensitive, okay? If you're typing your email into a submission form somewhere and you decide to capitalize certain letters, it may come through on the form as that. But once it goes through the email servers, it won't. Yeah, okay, so if you're sending an email, you can't then arrange to have your email come through as the sender with different capitalizations. Okay, and I'm going to show you what I mean, because I tested this. First of all, I tried to spoof an email to myself to test what they're saying here. I can't find one that works, okay? I tried a couple of them. Nothing has come through so far. Well, except one has come through, but it's come through in a very odd way. I'm going to show you exactly what I mean. Okay, so I went to a website, and I could only find like two spoofing email websites that were like seemingly operational anyways. So when I tried them both out, I sent one to two. I put in for this the person that was receiving the email. I'm sending it to one of my email addresses, slayerutica@live.com. Everyone knows that by now. But I put it in as being the person sending it as my ekcpeoplesuck@gmail.com email address. And when I put it in, when I typed it in there, I capitalized certain letters because I want to see if it came through like that. Well, it didn't come through. But I did receive an email on the EKC email, the one sending the email, effectively. So here's what they sent me. Mail delivery system. Undelivered mail returned to sender. I sent this through a proxy site, through a spoofing site. I didn't send it through my Gmail. I just put my Gmail down as being the sender. What they sent me was, this is the email system at host, emkei.cz. I'm sorry to have to inform you that your message cannot be delivered to one or more recipients it's attached to. And then it says down here why it wasn't sent, why it failed. But here's what I did. Here's one thing I did do. I sent, without going through the proxy site, I sent myself an email from myself. So I sent, and I did this with both platforms, just to try it out. So over on my Outlook, this is how it came through on my Outlook. I was able to type in the capitalization for who it was going to, because that's the part you type in. You don't type in though who it's from, because your email server knows who's sending it. They know who it's from. They don't need you to input that. So you don't get to change that in your email. So for the screenshot in which Nikki has, I don't know how that would be capitalized. I don't get it. But let me show you something else here, though, too. So and then I sent it from my Outlook here to the Gmail. Hopefully you can see that drop-down menu. But as you can see, it's from Slayer Utica. And now, when I typed it, when I typed this from my Slayer Utica to me, I capitalized the EK, certain letters of the EKC. And as you can see, that's not coming through, nor is it coming through. It's nothing's capitalized. No matter what I tried to do, nothing got capitalized here. So this is all very strange. So I kept trying to spoof an email to myself, though, because I really wanted to test this whole capitalization thing. I can't find it, any site that will work. This is all I do find, is prank shit, where you can set up screenshots. This came, as you see here, I put my own information or whatever in here. You know, I personalized it, I guess. But when you pull up the site, there's already like a template plate there that just has whatever filled in. And then you go here to your left here and you fill out each one differently. So like here, if I want battery percent, it's okay, for those who missed it, see here the 5G on the picture on the right, it's showing full battery. Here, I'm gonna go to battery percent. I'm gonna put in 5%. See, the bar goes right down. See, it's, so it fixes your screenshot how you want it. You just input it here on the left. And this is what it makes. And see, and it says here too, I got the capitalization to show differently. But I'm not showing a from email though either. Okay. Now, just show. See, and now it's showing all capitalized how I wanted it. But this isn't real. This isn't a real email. This is just a faked screenshot. So in order for this to be the case, then everyone who's showing a picture with a difference in capitalization would have to be making fake screenshots. And of course, I don't believe that to be the case at all. So I don't know. Here's what we do know. Let's just focus on what we do absolutely know. We do know that no one has been arrested in the States for any of these things done. We do know that it's been alleged that there's been CP sent to people. There's been reports made to all kinds of government body agencies or whatever, and several of them too. There's been threats of harm. There's been more though than just that. And I'm not sure, I think most people are aware of this, but most people may have forgotten this as well. Now, I'm not going to show these, but because they're kind of gross and I don't want to put this in from, I don't want to show this on a fucking YouTube video. So I'm just going to read to you, okay? There's this one example I'm going to be reading where there was a, I don't know if it was considered credible. I would have taken it seriously, and I don't really take much of anything seriously. But if I received this, I would have taken it seriously. But this was sent to Salts, I believe, and they were threatening to blow up his place of worship, and he's Jewish, so it was a synagogue. But it says, Temple Eliah, whatever, your wife teaches a class at. Nice place. Be a shame if something were to happen at the next event. Well, I don't want to use this. I don't want to say what it said. Say, make the same stench the Nazis did. It just won't. Okay, I'm not going to keep reading this. But yeah, that's what was said about this place of worship where the attorney for the other side attended. And I believe he had said at one point that even a congressman was a member there. So, but nothing came of this. No arrests were made. That's crazy. But there's more. Oh, there's more. In addition to that, the attorney had minor children or teenagers, I think. And I'm not going to read these because these are even more gross. But someone allegedly had written, DM'd, it looks like, one of these minor children and said all kinds of gross, disturbing, inappropriate things to them. No one got in any trouble for that. You know, it's just, I don't understand why no one got into any kind of serious consequences for this, for any of this. It doesn't make sense to me. Now, I get that Natalie doesn't live here. Okay, she lives in the UK. So the claim and the assertions from like Katie Joy, for example, that all these things were happening is a bunch of bullshit. Because if you remember, here's what we do know that she said. She said in 2021, when she wore like her purple mama bear shirt or some shit like that, or some, I forget. saying how my stalker's finally been arrested. That video was scrubbed from her channel. It scrubbed so much so that if you go to Playboard and you pull up her videos and you click to look at the deleted and unlisted, it's not there. It's not even on the deleted list. But then if you go through her published videos and you scroll all the way back to that time, that date in which it was posted, you'll see it listed, but you can't access it because it says it was deleted. But it's not on the delete list. I'm not all over Playboard going through everyone's catalog, but anytime I've gone through catalogs and found deleted, I've never seen shit like that. This is the first time I've seen shit like that. That's all I'm saying. But that video there, which she's proudly sharing with everyone, how Natalie was arrested, is gone. She took it down. Why? And the only other time she talked about that, this after then, was about a year later. It was in 2022 she made that video, I think. No, I don't remember. I can't remember. Yeah, it was 22 when she was allegedly arrested. Then I think it was a few months later, it was in fall, when she came out and said that the investigation for in the UK had been dropped or closed or whatever, nothing was coming from it. But only because the investigator was now opening up a brand new investigation and making Katie Joy the center victim, or the sole victim or whatever. And so Katie Joy had to relive all this trauma as she went through all of her screenshots to send everything to the investigator again. That's bullshit. Nothing like that happened. Nothing came of it. As of today, there's no investigation into Natalie Kennett in the UK. She is in no trouble. Nothing. So everything I just read off to you happened, allegedly. But not a single person could adequately be blamed, even to the point where there was a criminal charge in the States or even in the UK. Not one person. We do know that Unirock sent that, or Unirage sent that message of support there for Katie. We do know that when Katie got these recovery emails or whatever, she ran right to Twitter and knew exactly who to blame. We do know that there's not many lows in which Katie is opposed to venturing down to, if it means that she gets the benefit in some way. And she does benefit. Now, she's trying to win over the court of public opinion. Now, over on Twitter, when she was being sued by Tati, the public opinion was not on her side. She needed to somehow make herself the victim again. Now, let's remember, when this lawsuit came out, it was 2020. Tati Westbrook was still not the most liked person on social media. This was after the whole drama again and bi sister thing or whatever. This is back when everyone really loved and supported James Charles too. Remember, this is the time in which the lawsuit happened. So Katie was at that time such a hated person that she was able to present Tati in the victimhood light when At that time, everyone viewed Tati as an instigator, a hated person. Katie was able to martyr Tati. What we do know about from when it happened before is Katie went through a list of people she was pointing the finger at. There was Steve, there was Tina, there was me, there was Dottie. Charlotte, I think she even blamed at one point. And, you know, if someone were threatening my kid, I would want to be sure that I had the right person, because I wouldn't want to then feel bad for that person catching whatever shit came their way as a result of it. So I would want my child to be respected enough for a proper investigation so the proper person gets the just dessert. I think most people would. And most people's, their actions would then depict this. Well, Katie's actions depict something entirely different. Her actions depict that she wanted to use this to serve her and to hate at those who she thinks harmed her. Nothing she did, in my opinion, was on behalf of her child. It was only and all on behalf of her. She says that now authorities have been contacted because someone sent dominoes to their home, allegedly, that whatever. So again, she's not giving the investigators time and the chance, the opportunity to conduct a proper investigation and come to the actual cause of it and to be able to enact the proper consequence. She's muddying the waters and she's taking away their ability to do this. And she's using it for fodder on social media so she can convince people that this church out in California that has like 24 members or something to it is a danger to all of society. When you think about it, these were just stupid emails. There is no real threat to anyone. Say what you want. There wasn't. If all of these emails were indeed sent to someone by someone in the UK, did you really think that they were going to hop in a plane and jump over here during COVID? You know? So these weren't serious threats that the FBI or whoever would take seriously. So the idea that, and I bought into the idea of an investigation too. Hell, I even did a FOIA request on myself to see if they had any files on me. So the idea, though, of there being an actual investigation into this is kind of crazy. I don't buy it. Yeah, so I think it's Katie doing it this time because of the mistakes we're seeing, because the capitalization someone there pointed out, because of the receipts, things that I found out. These are things that I don't think would have happened last time, mostly because the follow-through was never claimed last time. Like, basically, you saw or you heard about an online claim made to an agency or CPS or whatever somewhere. But on the form, there was no identifying information. They gave somebody else's email address. They pretended to be someone else. They used a different name or whatever. They even gave like the description of events to be so incredibly outrageous that it's very likely to be untrue. So the follow-through, I don't feel, was quite there. But actually claiming that someone ordered a pizza to be brought to your fucking house, that's a follow-through. It's not the same people, I don't think. I think it's actually Katie running it this time, if that's the case. Oh, that's a good point. So here, this comment. Someone says, here's what I do know. There was some in the community that really went off the deep end of dramatic, takes over these emails and use that to manipulate people, giving them donations, asspats, and YouTube views. I absolutely hated that this was going on. And when I spoke out against it, I was told I was being mean to these various creators. Shrugs. Oh, now that just clicked. You might be right there. All right, I'm going to move on from there. I was thinking Unirock you were talking about first, but then I clicked. But, so if anyone receives any emails claiming to be from Nat or whatever, if Nat wants to contact you and wants you to know that it's her, she will take steps to assure to you it's her. She will send a voice recording. She'll work with you. So if anyone wants to verify it's Nat, I urge you to do so. Because in case people don't remember, I had someone come up in my inbox claiming to be Nat. So these were emails I received from Nat. And Nat and I had spoken prior to this, and we already had something worked out where I could verify it was her because people would do this. And this is exactly why I did that. So it starts off with, This is hereby served upon you, and sent a cease and desist, which was using the same... All right, I'm not going to get into that. So I said, hey, just out of curiosity, what recent discussion regarding you do you take issue with? Because I'm playing off of the cease and desist. Because I have barely streamed at all recently and haven't uploaded anything. And the one or two times I did stream this year where I might have mentioned you, I have stated the same claims as you have. And this you have, you know, in your letter above. I'm just wondering what the fuck you're talking about, I guess. But also, I can't know to cease and desist something if I don't know what this something is. So perhaps you can explain it to me like I'm five. They then reply, anything pertaining to my name being mentioned, your YouTube videos more so. I said, well, I can absolutely mention your name. you'll have to be more specific than that. But you know what? First, since this is yet another new email address, I meant to say, and the format that you wrote the cease and desist as on greatly differs from ones you've sent in the past, perhaps you can first prove that you are in fact you and not some troll using your name like there has been in the past. And I want to remind you too that this cease and desist form was an American form, and she lives in the UK. So it's weird that she used the same kind of template that's used in America rather than one that's used in the UK. So Natalie said, or the account then says, I don't need to prove anything to you, nor do I owe you an explanation. The document sent to you explained the things. I wish for you to remove harassing, false, and defamatory statements linking me or Katie Joy to any of the crimes mentioned. Why are you fucking mentioning Katie Joy? I said, but you do if you truly want me to know what to remove and what to avoid doing slash saying in the future. And as you know, or the real Natalie would know anyway, this name is often used by people who aren't Natalie. Natalie in the past has provided me with proof so I can know which emails are from her and which ones are not. So far, you are proving to be in the not column. You need to change that if I take any of this seriously. Thanks again. The account then says, if you decline to act upon the cease and desist cert, then in 30 days, action will be taken against you. You already have one case pending. Do you really want another? I said, well, of course no one wants to catch a case, but I'm not worried about it since you aren't you. But thank you so much for exchanging all of these back and forth emails with me. So much obliged. They then said, maybe if you learned the definitions of harassment, you wouldn't have caught the first one. I said, maybe, but then again, maybe what I said or did wasn't harassment. Why don't you explain it to me? Point out exactly what exactly I said or did crossing the line into legal harassment. I mean, how else will I learn if not taught, right? And while you're at it, tell me why you feel as though you can't tell me these things as who you truly are instead of hiding behind a Nat alt like you are. They said, when you're in court next week, I was thinking I had to go in the beginning of February. I don't know what I'm doing. When you're in court next week, you'll find out. It's disappointing at your age. You don't know what constitutes as defamatory statements or harassment, Aaron. Who the fuck was talking about defamation? Like, where did defamation come into play here? But don't give yourself away or anything there, Katie. Then again, your complete obsession of Katie Joy speaks volumes in itself. To which I say, this still begs the question, why the fuck aren't you coming at me with this as yourself? Why are you hiding behind Nat? Furthermore, how many times have you hid behind Nat? Why doesn't it bother you to use an alt that's allegedly responsible for creating CSAM? Oh my God, was it you that created that? Were you also then using the Nat name to do your dirty work? I mean, you don't type, talk, build sentences like her at all. I do see similarity with others, though. Is your real persona so badly tarnished that you can't use that anymore and you use Nat's instead? I mean, how badly did you burn your reputation? Why you gotta be such a pussy here and hide behind an alt? And an alt like Nat? Yeah, I know. You won't answer a fucking one. And then I came back with, again, oh my God, I just looked. Why are you, oh yeah, because the email tracker. Why are you opening the email so many times and so often? Like, as often as a few seconds apart. Are you on the edge of your seat waiting for my reply? Are you sharing it with others? Are you acting on behalf of someone else? Do tell. To which they say, you're deflecting the issue at hand, Aaron. Just like you did with the anti-vaxxers. With that person, been with Katie 30 days. I said, no, not at all. And I went into a little brief thing about anti-vaxxers and Katie or whatever. But, and then, oh, that email that I sent, by then they had deleted the account because I got the mailer demon. So yeah. But in regards to what it was I was talking about how they keep checking the emails, this is the all right, so I'll pull it up here. Oh yeah, I'll do it here. Okay. If you see here in the drop-down menu, you can see how often they pulled this up. They stopped pulling it up when they deleted the account. But you see here, there's seconds apart, and there's 27 of them. Look at that. Does that count for all of them or just in one? No, I think it counts for all of them. Oh, no. No, this is 23. Are they all individually numbered? 29? Yeah. So each, when you see these numbers, that's just for that specific sent email to them. It's not for the whole thread. If you add them up for the whole thread, it's probably like 200 or more. All within a very short period of time. Like, they sent me the first email at 9:38 a.m. I sent that last one out at 1:23. So we'll say 9:30, 10:30, 11:30, 12:30. 4 hours. 4 hours, and they probably opened up emails like hundreds of times. So this is why I highly suggest that if you get receive any emails from that, that you ask for verification, because there's been so many times where I've received an email allegedly from Nat and this other new email address. And it wasn't her. It wasn't from her. Someone, I think that whoever created this whole idea, this whole entity of Nat, whether she's a real person or not, it doesn't matter. I'm talking about for what she was to us. Whoever created this, okay, did this for their reason. But then people, I think, either got the idea or just saw something that they could use for their benefit, because they, for whatever reason, hated someone so much so that they wanted to borrow that face for a minute so they could say the thing that they want to say. Okay, so yeah, that's what we know. We know that no one was arrested, no one was charged. We know that Katie stopped talking about it, stopped pursuing anything, stopped caring, basically. We know that everyone else involved, you know, that was of an authority figure, whatever, stopped talking about it. We know that, I know that, anyway, that the investigator there in the UK doesn't know how to use email or something, apparently. But definitely doesn't want to reply to me. If you're going to sit there and disbelieve that Katie has any kind of hand in this, or that this is being concocted for a purpose to shape the public opinion regarding Katie or whatever is going on, then you need to ask yourself one question. How the fuck did Q happen? Now, I'm not saying that the same people are involved or whatever, but it's the same concept. It's the power of suggestion largely online. And if you set things up properly, then you can really shape someone's mind and someone's actions. I mean, there's been all kinds of studies and such done since Trump was elected there in 2016. And it's come out that these actors, these groups or whatever, these individuals were hired or were enlisted or whatever to shape the current zeitgeist in that election. And they did all different kinds of ways in which it's basically like hacking a human. If you just follow them enough on social media, you can do it, I think. It's mostly, I think, like the power of suggestion. Like if I were to imagine how I would do it, it would be that. It would be using bot accounts, using fake accounts to keep dropping the same narrative again and again and again until the person starts to buy into it. And then it's by and large what Katie's doing. She's trying to create this entire narrative. And there's a lot of accounts that are commenting on her shit that are seemingly fake accounts. They're all privated, first of all. I mean, that's a huge thing. Most people don't want, the majority of shit, people don't want their shit privated because the whole purpose of social media is to show things off. So if so many accounts are privated, I question that. Much of her followers are privated. And they're new accounts, or you can click on the about this account thing and it'll tell you how many times they changed their screen name. It won't tell you what their previous names were, but it'll tell you it's been changed 11 times and then the account's only like maybe a year and a half old. It's shit like that. And there's a lot of them. I'm going to advise people to just ask for proof on things. There's nothing wrong with that. If someone's trying to sell you a story and get you to believe it, they have to expect that you're going to want some sort of confirmation, some sort of purchasing insurance, if you will, before you buy it. And anyone who's reluctant to give that to you, it's because they're selling you shit. That's why. Anyone who's selling you exactly what it is they're claiming to be selling you will happily prove it to you and show you what it is you need to feel confident and comfortable with this purchase, if you will. Just ask for proof, ask for verification, ask for something, anything. And you don't even have to come up with the idea. Ask them to think of something if you can't think of what it would take. And then just take it from there. And anyone who gets mad at you for doing that, or anyone who gets mad at you for not believing them, it's because they got something riding on this. Anyone who stands firmly and with confidence behind the truth is patient and is fine with people taking a minute to get there if that's what they need. Katie's not patient. So don't go with speculation. Don't listen to what myself or anyone else has to speculate on, because I get a lot of speculation when it comes to Katie. Like, I think she even had a hand in Creepshow Arts, the whole thing, okay? But don't listen to me. Look at what you know. These few things that you know. You know no one was arrested. You know no one was held accountable. You know the affected parties allegedly moved on. You know Katie sat there on a live stream with Nat, telling people to not hate at Nat, knowing and admittingly so there on that stream that Nat was behind these things. She did that because she didn't care about the actual person as she was claiming it to be, that they be the ones who are held accountable. No, she did that because she wanted people who weren't to blame to be held accountable. She wanted to use this situation, use her son being, as she put it, targeted in this way. She wanted to use that and exploit it to turn the hate against those who did her wrong. Lastly, I'm going to end this with this here, because I have a question. Ask yourself, why is it that when names are mentioned in these emails or these threats or whatever, why is it that the only names mentioned are names that Katie has had issue with or fought with? No one, out of all the people mentioned, not one of them is someone that Katie has been on friendly terms with, is someone she admires or someone she gets along with. No one like that has been mentioned. So let me explain to you a little bit more what I mean. And this is, I'm going to read to you an email. This is an email that I had sent someone back in 2021, kind of like at the beginning of this. So someone had asked me if I thought someone was involved, and a couple other people. And I gave my honest, so I said, okay, so real quick, my honest and complete opinion on this is that, for starters, I bet my house on it that it's not Tina in any way. It's not something she'd do, and it's definitely not something she could do. She struggles with technology. And he'd asked this person, so I asked me about Steve, and I said, or about Steve's crew. I said, I don't know any of Steve's crew, so I can't give an opinion there. And this is back in 2021, so I hadn't known Steve for that long. I said, I do know Steve a bit, though. More importantly, I've known him longer than I've known anyone else here involved in YouTube and drama, except for Katie. I've known her the longest. Though I may not be as confident that it's, I may not be confident enough to bet my house on it that it's not Steve, but I bet everything in my house on that it's not Steve. So mostly though, I think Katie is plausibly involved. I'm not looking for that to be the case, mind you. I have no dog in this fight. I just know from experience that she has no issues manufacturing situations that cause problems and drama. On Facebook, we all had sock accounts to monitor the anti-vax groups, but very rarely would any of us cause a scene in the groups, post inflammatory shit, or troll anti-vaxxers. We all probably had our reasons, but I just never wanted to contribute to their crazy. I wasn't there to make them worse. Katie went out of her way to fuck with them and happily write about their behavior. There was this other incident with this colleague that had Katie messaging me to get info on him. That's a long story, whatever. Except, I learned a couple days after that, after she and I talked, that she already knew all this info when she reached out to me and was hoping to insert herself in his situation to make shit worse for him. Maybe it's argued whether or not he deserved it, but whatever. I said, that's not my problem, though. I said, I read in a science Facebook group that she planned on getting info from me, or dirt she thought I had, and using it against him and throwing me under the bus while doing so. I don't know why, though. I never even talked to this person. I still haven't. I was just familiar with this person that he was fighting with and saw it as all of being a vendetta. Said she enjoys messing with people and getting away with it. I mean, I guess a lot of people do, but most people don't get so giddy about it. But that's not my biggest reason for suspecting her. It's my first reason, but it's not my biggest. My biggest reason is the past few days, almost a week, I'd say, the lies she's been telling, the stretching she's been doing to place all blame for everything that upset her the past 2 years on this situation. To claim it was all Creepshow art, then Tina, then the subreddit, Little Red, Unirock, and some others in her chat who ask her a question, causing her to give an answer she doesn't enjoy giving. She told her viewers she had been swatted and had cops at her house 3 times in a week due to her stalker making files or false reports. There's 2 Instagram streams she did. I don't know if they're still up or whatever, but in those two videos and her Twitter is why I am now leaning toward my original opinion about this when it first started in January. And that is, she has played a part in orchestrating much or some of these acts to make it look like she's being targeted. I don't think she's penning and sending the emails, but I think she's the one causing them to be created. But when you said whoever it is obsessed with all things Katie, well, no one is anywhere near as obsessed with all things Katie than Katie. And seeing how so much shit is being mentioned involving people she's fought with in the past, I wonder, is it someone obsessed with Katie? Or is it someone obsessed with those who have wronged Katie? And that is where I land today. But more importantly, I'm not going to breathe any life into this shit. I don't think it's going to last or stay around long anyways, because unless and until it benefits Katie, there's no need for it, right? All right, I'm done. Bye. I still feel like I forgot some. Okay, now it's time for member shoutouts. I'd like to thank
Miss Ellie 85, Sunshine and Rain, Renelle Smith, Aaron Matheson, Babs 5678, Tax Max Fax Thunderclap, Sassy Nods, Elizabeth Brodna, Taboo Topics, Fayette, Edward Catbush, Heather Mama of 5, DC, Sally Godfrey, Babs Cat, Cheryl, Mr. Blackwell, Hank Texas, Tammy Sue, Randa Smith, Estella Havisham, Lazy Wilt, Queen Donnie, Tequila Alive and Me, Rita Rue, Linda Reese, Channel Has Been Deleted, Indigo Halo, Nana Hawk, Leah, Sean Coffey, Cheryl Tobiasen, Crafty Florida Lady, Sakara Bear, Sassy Elmo, Flying Mom Laura, Berber, Virillion, Purple Dragon Chill, I'm Fucking Raken, Oz Bell, Sunny D, Jen Gerard, and Poodlerific.
Thank you so much for joining, and thank you everyone for watching.